Linda Israel here. The scent of the day is Pink Champagne. This is a soy wax melt. Check out the link description in my box below. They have jewelry inside. Today I'm working on a junk journal using the digital images from the Calico Collage Shop. This is called Spring Peacock. They have beautiful digital images. So today I have pre-selected a few of the images that I'm going to put in my journal. And what I've done is I've got some 8.5 by 11 text weight paper that I have cut down to be 7.5 inches and left it at 11 inches. I've picked a few of the image that I want to put on the pages, and I'm going to start adhering them, adding stamping, embellishments, some Tattered Angels glimmer mists and whatnot. So come along and watch me create. This is a pocket that I learned how to make. Lindsay in the Calico Collage design team shared this, and she said that this was made by Crafty Irina. The concept is you take a sheet of paper, in this case it's a page out of an old dictionary, and you fold it in half in the portrait mode. Then you take the corner of one of the fold pieces and fold it down. And then you take the next corner and don't fold it all the way down, but just partially down. And close this back up so that you have two pieces that are folded. Then take the back portion and meet it to the front. So now you have a piece that has these two places and the back. And then what they showed on their channels was to then glue this side and down this side. Well, I decided to do it a little bit differently. What I've done is I am going to make one more tuck down, and that is to fold it not quite as far as the others, just a little bit, and fold that down. And then I took some washi tape. This one just so happens to be a butterfly washi tape from Tim Holtz. And then, let me get this piece of paper out of the way. I take a piece of that along this edge. And it's overlapping just a little bit. I cut it even at the top. So it's going over the back. I trim off the excess at the bottom. And then I fold it over. So what that did was that sealed that side, and now you have all of these pieces to be a pocket. Now what you can do before you seal that up is you can even go in and lay washi tape on each of these edges. I've got a narrow washi tape here, so I'm going to take a piece of that and go along this edge here. As soon as I figure out where the end is. Then I'm going to take a piece of this washi tape in the butterfly and go across the edge this way. I just fold over the edge. I'm going to take some of the blue. Now I can stop there, and I'm not going to. I'm going to add some more to it. I've got some Glimmer Mist. This is Pop Rocks, and I'm going to spritz it just a little bit. That just adds a little bit of color. I have a spring peacock image here that I cut out with my Silhouette. And what I'm going to do with that is adhere that down on here, but I'm also going to add a piece of, where'd it go? I lost it. Ah, here we go. We'll just use this. I got another piece, just a random piece of washi tape that was left over, just to add a little more color and interest. I'm just going to adhere this down. I've got some Aline's tacky glue. You could add all kinds of things, other trims, lace trims, a little bow, but that's just a quick little pocket that Crafty Irina on YouTube shared. She does it a little bit differently, but I wanted to have a pocket here, 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 and if you only glue this side in this way, you'll actually have four pockets if you so choose when you glue it down in a journal. So that's what I did, and making sure I've got this right side up, I'm going to glue it down inside my journal page this way. When you're gluing something into a journal page, you want to make sure that you don't use a tape at the bottom if you're going to use it as a pocket, because any item that you put in, if it hits the bottom where that tape is, it will stick to it and you won't be able to get it out. And it'll be a mess and you'll rip it and you'll be very sad. So I use glue instead of tapes. And then I've got some of the calico collage images that I have gone around with the distressed inked, and this is a little peacock feather, and they're on index cards, so those can be popped into the pockets. And then there's even one more spot in the back, so you actually have four places that you can put things. Thank you. All right, so I need to cut the chipboard for my covers. So if I'm measuring out the pages, it is 5.5 inches by 7.5 inches. So I want a little bit of a space on my covers. So I'm going to go to 5.75 inches. So that'll be how wide the page will be. So I'm going to cut two of those. Turn this over so I don't get a bent corner. So there's one. And there's another. And then we said this was 7.5, so we're going to go to 7.75. That's how long or tall these need to be. So that's my front and back, but I need a spine. So I've got another piece of chipboard here, and I know that I want my spine to be 1 inch because that's how wide my pages were. Actually, I'm going to go 1 and an eighth. That way I have room for all the goodies that are added. And then we need this to be 7.75. Okay. I use my big heavy cutter when I'm cutting chipboard. And that's by Fiskars. So now I know that I have these pieces here. I need to cut paper to cover these. I've got a couple of pieces of scrapbook paper that I'm going to cut down to cover my covers. Now, when you're covering your front and back covers for a journal, you need to allow for more paper to be able to go around your front and back. So I want to go to about 6.75 inches will give me enough to go all the way around. If I were to go to 6 inches exactly, I wouldn't have enough to go all the way around. So I don't have enough to do 2 out of 1 sheet of paper. So I'll have to go to about 6.75, and then I'll trim this down. And I'll do the same with the next sheet of paper. 6.75. I'm going to go out to 8.75, and I'm going to cut both at the same time. And I have some bookbinder's tape, and that's what I'm going to use to cover the center spine when I go to put that together. So what I like to do is use Aline's tacky glue and just place glue on the chipboard all the way around. Kind of make a zigzag in the middle. Place this in the dead center of my paper. Then I'll use my bone folder to smooth this out. I'll flip it over and smooth it out on the other side as well. That just helps the glue to spread. And then I'll take my bone folder and score on all the sides. I'll take this corner and fold it in and score it. And I'll do that on all four corners. Once I have all those scored, I'll put just a little bit of glue under each tab. And then I'll fold each side over and score. And then I'll glue this all down. I think I'm about due for a new bottle of glue. I can eke just a little bit more out. I'm going to repeat it for the other cover. I'm going to go ahead and cover the center spine just so that it's covered on both sides. So I'm just cutting a piece of paper so that I can wrap it. All right, so I've got my bookbinding tape. I've made a little bit of a gap between, I'm going to do this a little bit differently. I want to use washi tape to hold this in place because they tend to move around and you want a gap between them until you get it all settled. so that it can bend and open. So I've got a piece of this bookbinding tape, and you cut it longer than you need because you're going to wrap it around. You're going to get it centered. And you smooth it out. Then flip it over. There is the cover. Let's clean up here. I've got a piece of seam binding here that I'm going to use as the tie. I've got my ATG gun, so I'm just going to put a little bit of that to help keep the seam binding secure, because I'm going to adhere down one of the pages. I'm going to go around the edge with some distressing, then we'll adhere that down on top. This is my bookbinding template to punch holes when I am making a simple book, but since I'm making one with a special cover, I need to make one that will match up when I make the cover. So what I've got here is I've made another template to match up to my cover that has three score marks where the placement of each signature is going to be. I'm getting my awl out that I use for bookbinding. And I've lined up the score. It's hard to see, I'm sure, in the video, but there's a score line down here. And I'm just going to poke a hole in the three spots down the center of that. And then I'm lining this up with the next score mark, making sure I've got this even. And then I'm going to punch a hole, and then I go the other side. Yep, those are coming out just fine. There's lots of ways to do this. I'm not a measurer. I'm an eyeball person. I just kind of look at it and say, okay, yeah, that looks good. So that's pretty close to what it should be. And what I'm going to do next is I'll take this template to poke holes in my spine of my book so that when I go to sew my signatures in, they'll all have a place to sew it in. So all my holes have been punched, and now it's time to get the signatures and get those ready. I forgot to do the inside covers. I picked out a couple of sheets of the Calico Collage, and I'm going to paste those on the inside here. I want that one there, and this one over here. Change my mind. I decided to cover up the center because I didn't like the way that washi tape looked, and I'm just going to re-poke my holes. I know this looks really weird on my table. This is my book binding cradle. This is something my husband made for me. There are other kinds of book binding cradles out there that you can buy. I knew that when I was doing book binding that I wanted something that would be sturdy and I wouldn't have to worry about it collapsing on me. So he made me this. It looks kind of like a feed trough, has a hole at the bottom, and you put your pages inside, you line up your template, and then you just poke through all of your pages and get your line of your holes that you need. And it makes it so much easier when you go to bind your book together. So you can see all the holes have been punched and they're ready now for me to load up my wax linen thread. I have this Bind It All kit. It's just a kit that has all these book binding tools, and it's kind of handy because that's where my needle is. So when you're doing your book, you want to go and cut one, two, about three times the length that you need, just in case. So you don't have to worry about, oh, I don't have enough. I'd rather have too much than too little. Wherever you start your tail, that's where it will end. I want mine to end in the center. So I'm going to start in the center and poke through to the outside. So I'm starting here. I'm also starting with my center signature. And then I'll put the others on the other side. So you want to pull through, and then you'll pull, and then you'll want to hang on. Ah, the pages are going crazy. I'm going to hang on to this tail with one finger, and then come up to your other hole at the top and poke through all your pages. You may have to finesse it just a little bit to get them all to line up. And you'll come down the center hole again. The center hole. Dealing with this lace, trying to make sure I capture it. To the bottom hole, through all your pages, back to the inside. Then I like to tie a knot. And then I tie a second knot. With the wax linen thread, it doesn't slide, so you don't have to worry about it so much as coming apart. You can tie a little bow if you like to make it look pretty. Leave the ends if you want. You can add little dangles in there. And I'm just going to repeat this process on the other two signatures. All right, so now I've bound the journal and it is complete. This is Linda Israel here, and I want to show you my completed journal that I made using the Calico Collage, the Spring Peacock journal kit. For those of you that didn't know, I'm in the design team with Calico Collage, and one day the creator asked for some ideas of a kit to make. I gave her some tips of colors that I enjoyed and said peacocks and butterflies and purples and pinks and teals together, and she came back with this kit. So I kind of helped inspired this kit, and I thought it was only fitting that I hurry up and make this. It's only taken me a month to get to this. I have had a very busy month. So I have made a tutorial that'll be posting in a day or two as soon as I get the video edited. It was rather long, a little over probably 4 hours that I spent stop and go to get this put together. So I have a chipboard cover that I made for this, and then on the inside these are text weight papers that I have sprayed with Glimmer Mist. The first page has a pocket right here at the top. There's nothing in this pocket at the moment. I'm leaving that to the person that ends up with the journal. I've left this spot here for them to write or add whatever they want. The next page has a tuck spot. This was a recycled piece from something that I purchased. Here's where the Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist were used. I used lots of different colors. For example, there was True Turquoise, Pop Rocks, Cranberry Zing, Blue Bubbles, Party Pink, Turquoise Blue, and Blarney was used. I also used index cards. So this was an index card, and this is a stamp from Michael's, one of their recollection sets. This is pieces out of the Spring Peacock journal kit. I also used some washi tape. This was a page out of a steno pad, just a small junior legal page. This is a pocket up here. I used some of her kit to make little paper clips. This is also in the kit. This butterfly stamp at the bottom is from Stampers Anonymous. This is also part of the journal kit, and there's a page open there. This is a pocket. This is a book page that I made by a pocket that I made by out of a book page in this washi tape. Here's another journal spot as well. Journal spot here as well. Some more of this beautiful papers. I just love all the colors that she used. These are from the kit as well. This is also from that stamp set from Recollections. This is one of the pockets that comes in the kit. Here's another pocket, and it was from Crafty. Oh, I've got to remember her name. It was from Crafty Arena. She had an idea of how to make a pocket, and I ended up making mine to have 1, 2, 3, 4 places to put things, and you'll see that in my full length video. Here's a little tuck spot. This is also out of the journal. This image here is from the domino set, and the circle is an enlarged out of the 1 inch. I have another video where I made the keychains that you can see that I enlarged those. So that's how nice these images are. You can enlarge them and still use them. Journal page. A page out of the journal kit. Here's another book page that I made. Some more pages here. This is another tuck spot just by gluing the edges of the butterflies. Here is a pocket that's included in the kit. Here's one of those other pockets that I made using Crafty Arena's idea. There's another journal page and tuck spot, journal area, another little tuck spot with washi tape. It's another paper clip I made using these pieces out of the journal kit. It's another pocket with pieces out of the journal kit. Another paper clip I made and a pocket. I just love all of the images. I didn't want to glue this one down, so I just tucked it in here. Another journal spot. These are some pockets. You know, some of these pages that I didn't show, I didn't glue all the way down on the top, so they've become what I think is hidden pockets. There's another one here. It's another pocket. The journal spot. Journal spot. Tuck spot. Journal spot. And I left these just sprayed with the Tattered Angels so they can be written on. I like to have places to write. I thought this was kind of neat. I stamped this peacock here and then stuck this on top of it. So it's kind of a peek-a-boo, if you will. And more journal spots. And then here's the back cover. And then the very back cover. And then this is tied with a piece of seam binding. So there is my quick flip through of my junk journal using things that I already had on hand, which was the Texwake paper that was a light sage green, and I ended up spraying it with Tattered Angels. Glimmer Mist, I used some Tim Holtz Distressed Inks, some Brutus Monroe Surface Inks, some stamps that I had, and of course the Calico Collage Digital Images. If you love this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with your friends so others can see what I made today and learn more about my channel. Subscribe if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, because I share all kinds of craftiness here. Thanks so much for watching. I greatly appreciate each and every one of you. Check out the link descriptions in the box below to find out where I got all these goodies. Have a fabulous day. Bye.